Hey guys, what's up? It's me, the Otaku Fangirl, here to review episode 8 of My Ouiga. Alright, so I'm sure by now most of you have stopped watching My Ouiga. I don't know, because after that one episode where we had the problem with the whole... The things they saw, like, the two episodes after that, episode 7 and episode 8, 6, maybe, I don't remember, but anyway, it's gotten, like, not worse, it's just kind of, like, steadily gone its path. Like, this episode was a little bit better than last week's, so you just kind of climbed the hill just a tiny bit. But anyway, in this episode, we got to find out Misaki's past. And what is her past? Well, she's been to the village before. With her cousin named Reiji, whose face we never got to see. And I was kind of hoping we would, because he might have been an attractive character, but you know, that's besides the point, doesn't really matter, so. And she and him found the village, she fell off a cliff, and woke up, and the road was in front of her, and I don't know what happened after that, because everyone started yelling at her, like, you're a liar, and stuff. So yeah, oh boy. What happened? Let's see. Oh, yeah. Then, after they all continued after yelling at her, the bus driver showed up and, like, tried to take her because he thinks she's a ghost. And then Mitsumune got on the bus with him. And then Hayato's shirt got caught in the bus. And all this stuff happened. And then everybody, after the bus drove away, everybody was like, well, what do we do? And then we got the most two interesting characters that I'm going to say for this entire series, Valkana and Koharun. They're my favorite characters of this entire series right now. Valkana and Koharun. Not because I ship the two, but that's kind of the reason. But yeah, she came to him. She's like, you know, I believe Misaki's story. She's my scapegoat. All this stuff. And she's like, well, would you help me get her back and stuff? And he's like, well, sure, why not? So those two go and... dang it, they had such a, like a... I don't want to call it a cute moment because it was kind of like a... saving her moment, like, because this character, Valkana, he reminds me a lot of a video game character named Shinjiro Aragaki from Persona 3. That's why I like him so much. But anyway, so he, like these arrows or whatever, like, got shot at them, and guess who's back? Hyo something no judgeness, he's back. I don't remember how to say his first name, his Chunibuyu name. He's back, and he's trying to kill them? Okay, and it was great because, like, well, it wasn't, well, it was kind of great because Val kind of grabbed her, and he also waited for her to catch up when they were walking, and I was like, oh, you sweetheart, what a sweetie, oh my gosh, I love characters like that who are, you know, tough guy on the outside and really sweet on the inside. I'm just like, oh wait, that's a tsundere, oh gosh. Anyway, so yeah, the judgeness dude's back. Where the heck Jack is, I don't know. And let's see. Oh yeah, the bus driver. Yeah, I don't know what's gonna go on with that, because in the preview for the next episode, there's a hand that appears on the window, and then Hayato's scared, and then, yeah, stuff happens, and... yeah, My Ouiga. I'm gonna keep watching, gonna keep reviewing, but will it get better? Probably not, which is kind of sad. This could have been really good. I mean, it's like, it's not so bad where I'm cringing the entire time, like that one episode, but every episode after where they saw visions of what they're most scared of, like, it didn't make me have a cringe fest. That episode may have a cringe fest. These past few episodes haven't made me cringe, they just made me go, huh, okay. So yeah, that was My Ouiga episode 8 review. I don't got much else to say. Koharun, Valkana, OTP. Anyway, I'll see you guys in my next review for Sakamoto and Kiznaiver. So yeah, see you guys then, okay? Bye-bye!